आज আমরা রাইট সাইডের হেমিসেকশন অফ হেড এন্ড নেক রিজন আইডেন্টিফিকেশন এবং রিলেটেড কিছু প্রফ কোশ্চেন নিয়ে আলোচনা করব। এট ফার্স্ট আইডেন্টিফিকেশন অফ দা ভিসেরা। দিস ইজ স্কাল। ক্রেনিয়াল বোনস। দিস থিন লেয়ার ইজ মেনিনজিয়াল ডুরা। This total cavity is called cranial cavity. This one is nasal cavity and this one is oral cavity. Within the cranial cavity, this is cerebrum, corpus callosum, thalamus, hypothalamus, midbrain, pons, medulla oblongata, cerebellum and spinal cord. Bones er majhe ache frontal, parietal, occipital ebong kichu vertebra, cervical vertebra. This one is first cervical vertebra or atlas. This total is cervical second vertebra or axis, cervical third vertebra, cervical fourth vertebra, cervical fifth vertebra, and in between vertebra there is intervertebral discs. This is hard palate. Posterior to hard palate, this one is soft palate. Within the oral cavity, this one is tongue, genioglossus muscle of the tongue. This is mandible. Now, prof questions which is commonly asked in the oral part of our professional examination. That is the layers of the skull at first. How many layers? It has 5 layers. From upwards to inwards, skin, superficial fascia, deep fascia in the form of epicranial apomorosis, loose areolar tissue and pericranium. This is dura mater. It has 2 layers, endosteal dura and meningeal dura. Endosteal dura is fused with the inner surface of the cranial bones, and meningeal dura forms 4 folds in the cranial cavity. One is fox cerebri, which lies within the 2 cerebrum. Here this space fox cerebri lies. This one is tentorium cerebelli. It separates cerebrum from the cerebellum. This is fox cerebelli. It lies in between 2 cerebellar hemispheres, and diaphragmatic cilia. It lies above the sphenoid bone here and surround the pituitary gland. Now, parts of corpus callosum. This thin portion is called rostrum, genu, body and splenium. Corpus callosum is a commissural fiber, that means it is white matter. This is thalamus, this one is hypothalamus, these are gray matter on central nervous system. This is superior colliculus and this one is inferior colliculus. By this we can identify this region, this total region is midbrain. This one is pons. This is medulla oblongata. Here in between 2 thalamus, third ventricle lies, and from the third ventricle through the cerebral aqueduct, it lies here in front of the 2 colliculus within the midbrain. This cerebral aqueduct connects the fourth ventricle. This one is the fourth ventricle. It lies in front of the cerebellum, behind the pons and medulla oblongata. And from the fourth ventricle, the cerebrospinal fluid goes to the subacnar space of the meninges, and few goes to the central canal of the spinal cord. Now, nasal cavity. Lining epithelium of the nasal cavity is divided into three types. Here, olfactory zone, it is lined by mucosal olfactory epithelium. Here, this is nostrils, it is lined by skin, that is keratinized stratified squamous epithelium. And rest of the part of the nasal cavity is lined by respiratory epithelium, that is pseudostratified ciliated columnar epithelium. This one is heart palate. The lining epithelium of the heart palate is above the heart palate, that means the area which is continuous with the nasal cavity, it is lined by respiratory epithelium, that is pseudostratified ciliated columnar epithelium. Below the heart palate, it is continuous with the oral cavity, so it is lined by non-keratinized stratified squamous epithelium. Short palate, it is attached with the heart palate, so it is skeletal muscle. It has five muscles. This is tongue. It is also skeletal muscle. That means it is a muscular structure. Now pharynx. Behind the nasal cavity, this area is called nasopharynx. Behind the oral cavity, this area is called oropharynx, and behind the larynx, this area is called laryngopharynx. That means this area taken where the stick lies is the pharynx. That means this portion is nasopharynx, this portion is oropharynx, and this portion is laryngopharynx. Now the extension of pharynx. Whole pharynx is extend from the base of the skull, lower margin of the base of the skull, to lower margin of the cervical 6 vertebra. The nasopharynx, it starts from the base of the skull to cervical 1 vertebra, atlas. The anteriorly, it starts from the posterior nasal aperture to tip of the soft palate. The oropharynx start from the tip of the soft palate to upper margin of the epiglottis. That means this region is oropharynx. And the vertebral level is cervical 2 and cervical 3 upper margin. And the laryngopharynx starts from the upper margin of the epiglottis to lower margin of the cricoid cartilage. That means cervical 4 to cervical 6 vertebra. In front of the pharynx, this passage is called larynx. It starts from the upper margin of the epiglottis to lower margin of the cricoid cartilage, and vertebral level is cervical 4 to cervical 6 vertebra.